Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video and checking out your girl. So today's video, I'm not even gonna lie, we're just gonna get straight into it because like, I won't say I'm shy on camera, but still a little not myself, still a little breaking out of my shell. So yeah, don't like clock me too much if I do some weird stuff. I'm just gonna have to pretend someone is here looking at me because me talking on camera, like I'm so used to voiceovers and I'd rather do voiceovers, but I'm trying to break out my shell a little bit, okay? So this story time is about the times that my clients played me. They did not care about me. They did not care about my sanity. They did not care about my well-being. And I'm laughing now, but in the moment I was hurt. In the moment I was just like, what is going on with y'all? These clients played me like these boys play us. Well, attempt to play us. These girls play me like these boys attempt to play us. So before we get right into it, make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up because I know who you are. You'll be coming back to watch my video every single day. You won't even do as much as like. You won't even comment. You haven't even subscribed, but you're still here every single video. Like, I know you get my notifications. I know you see me on your recommended page. The least you could do is subscribe. Like, I promise you, you're gonna love it here, okay? So yeah, into the story time. If you know me personally or like you just know of me, you know that I've been doing hair for a minute. For as long as I can remember, I've been touching somebody's hair. Whether it's my cousins, my mom, my sister, whether it's your dad's husband's sister, I've just been doing people's hair. So I've come in contact with a lot of mess. The aunties that don't be wanting to pay me, they'll be doing, you know, they'll be doing fake. Oh, my sweetie, my darling, just to get me to do their hair, or they'll try to, you know, finesse me out of a quick buck. I've been through the friend discounts. I've been through all of it. Every single phase of being a hairstylist, and with being so young, like, it just made it so much worse. So yeah, I've been doing hair since I was 9, but by the time I was 14 or 15, I decided to like really just make it a side hustle. Like, I might as well be making money from it, because for such a long time I was just doing it just because I like doing it and just because like people are around, so you know, I just wanted to do it. And girl, the stories, man, like, people just don't care, especially when you're so young. People don't care. I was so naive, so vulnerable, and me being the people pleaser that I am, it made the situation a lot worse. I was taken advantage of so many times by people I know, by people who claim to, you know, be on my good side, or like claim to love me for me but not for like what I can provide for them. It was disgusting. Like, looking back now, it's just like I really put up with a lot. But yeah, to share these stories, I'm not sharing it to say that I was the perfect stylist. Now believe me, I was young, so I made a lot of mistakes coming up. I made a lot of mistakes. And with doing hair at such a young age, like, it came with so many hurdles. A lot that I had no control of. For example, like, imagine you have a couple of appointments set out for like the next couple of weeks and I get in trouble at home. And now my parents are saying, oh no, you can't do hair, this and the third, because you know, that was their go-to punishment for me. Imagine just telling your clients like, hey, yeah, we're gonna have to reschedule, or I can't do your hair because my parents did it. Like, just imagine, like, bro, oh my God. Like, just imagine that being the reason why you're appointment is canceled. Like, I would be pissed. I felt so bad for them, but it's like, I have to respect my parents, you know what I mean? So this will be kind of an accumulation of stories. I just wanted to share the ones that like really stuck with me and like the ones that really made me change certain things, change certain rules, certain guidelines that I had, because they're the ones that really stuck. Me being a people pleaser, like, I'll really let anybody do whatever, just as long as, you know, that mutual respect is there. But for me to say, you have me messed up, and for me to go on my website, change the policies and everything, just so that nobody else can even think of doing what these people did, like, it was a lot. And honestly, my main purpose for this video, I think, is more so just to like show other people, especially people who are coming into doing hair or like becoming a stylist or like selling a product or anything that, you know, just involves people. I feel like no matter what age, stories like this come in handy just so you can learn from somebody else's, learn from my mistakes. And two, especially if you're so young, it's just to show you, like, don't be vulnerable. Don't let people take advantage of you. Don't allow it, because it's not worth it. So in this video, I'll be sharing two stories. I promise I won't make them too long or anything, but I have so many other stories. Like, I honestly wish I could tell y'all so much more in this one video alone, but if y'all want a part two, honestly, I will give a part two, because girl. So first story. So this dates back to 2017, the summer of 2017. Now I have like my appointment-based website and everything like that. But before I had that, I had everyone text me through my number. So, you know, this girl texts me. She tells me the hairstyle that she wants. We get everything situated. Okay, so boom, your appointment is on this date. This is how much everything is. This is what you're going to need to bring for your appointment. You know, I didn't really have any other type of rules. Like, you know, like now hairstylists, like, they'll have, you can only come with one person. You can't bring a dog. You can't bring your baby. You have to come 10 minutes minutes before your appointment. If you come 9 minutes before your appointment or 2 minutes after your appointment, you're getting charged with 15. I didn't have none of that. So it's just pretty simple. I just kind of hope that people just had that mutual respect. As long as you come in, get what you need to get done, and then you leave, that's it. So we have our appointment set. Day of her appointment, it's 7 a.m. This is the time that I always started my appointments. My mom is home. My brother is home. My sister is home. My father is home. And everybody's probably still sleeping. So this girl comes. She walks in. Another one walks in behind her. Another one walks in behind her. Another one walks in behind her. Mind you, one person is getting their hair done, but she pulled up with four friends. Why? Where are y'all gonna sit? Who's feeding you? You're here for no more than 3 hours. What do you need four other people for? This was before I knew what her motive was. So all of her four friends walk in. She sits down and I'm looking at the friends. They just settled, literally just sat down on the couch, and everybody was just chilling, just acting like this was their own house. Mind you, as I'm doing the girl's hair, one falls asleep, another one falls asleep. Mind you, when you fall asleep, in most cases, you're getting comfortable. These four girls get so comfortable on this couch. You're not even supposed to be here. This isn't your house. I don't know you from nowhere. Why are you this comfortable on a, like, it, the math was not, it just was not making sense. It wasn't clicking to me what you needed to bring four people for. I'm pretty sure my mom walked out at some point and like just looked around and was like, what's going on? She gets her hair done. I do everything, you know, the way she wants it, and it's time to pay. I think right before I even started like finishing up, because you know you can tell when your hairstylist is like pretty much done with your hair, got the water boiling, everything is, you know, getting set up, probably snipping, you know, the flyaways and everything off. This is when like things just start going shady. Things are not adding up. She's like, yeah, my check hasn't come in yet. I'm still waiting for my payment to come in, or like my check to come in so I can pay you. I thought it was gonna come in by this morning, but it hasn't yet. Me being me, I'm not going to like get feisty. I'm not gonna like throw an attitude. I'm not gonna throw shade or nothing like that. I was just like, okay, yeah, that's fine. Like, you know, just keep it professional. Yeah, it's fine. Everything's cool. Like, there's no problem. So she tells me she needs to go to the bank. I'm telling her, okay, this is the closest Wells Fargo because that's her bank. And she's like, okay, bet. So as soon as I'm done with her hair, I should have been smarter and at least made sure that one of her friends stuck around. That way, you know, you're gonna come back for your friend. But this girl leaves, and Wells Fargo is no more than 5 minutes from my house. Within the next like 20-30 minutes, I'm already texting her like, hey, like, are you having issues with getting to your destination? Like, what's going on? Keeping it as professional as possible. She's just giving excuses as to like why her check hasn't come in yet. She can't withdraw the money, something like that. I'm like, okay, like, that's fine, that's cool. Mind you, this girl's appointment was at 7. We were done by 10. 4 hours later, like around 2 or 3 o'clock, I'm still asking this girl, what's going on? Where's the money? This and a third. So she's giving excuses. At this point, I'm like, okay, I can smell BS from a mile away. I should have smelt it earlier, but my nose, you know, it's too early in the morning, so my nose wasn't smelling correctly at the time. But now, all right, yeah, you got me bent. What's going on? I'm like, okay, you know what? I think I had her number, so I think like on Cash App, you can put somebody's number in. So I put her number in and I start requesting the hell out of this girl. I'm requesting my money from her. $60, mind you, just $60. And she's declining. I request again, she declines. I request again, she declines. I think by the third or fourth time, she blocked me on Cash App. A bit of me wanted to let it go because, like, I'm not gonna lie, she looked very hood like me. I'm not trying to get into any troubles. Like, please, my life is worth more than $60. So whatever, you can have it, have the $60. God punish you and God will take care of everything for me. So at a point, I wanted to wash my hands clean, but I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna send this girl a message. So I sent her a message, this and a third. I didn't get a response from her. I'm pretty sure she blocked me. So I was just like, wow. So it was after like everything going on, like it started making sense. She probably pulled up with four friends just to make sure that, like, one, if she tries to, you know, do some snipe shit, and, you know, if I was one of those clients that like wanted to, you know, fight or whatever for the money, she probably had her girls to back her up. Like, nah, people's motives are just so off. After that point, I started making sure that I'm making it known as much as possible, please do not come with anybody. And if you do need to come with somebody, come with one person. I try to be as reasonable and understanding as possible. Like, if you want to come with somebody, like, that's totally fine. Like, I'm not, you know, pushing anybody away, but I don't want to start thinking, what is your motive for bringing this person? You know what I mean? It's just like, $60, dog. Like, it's $60. It's $60. Three 20s. You've got to be better than that. So this next story time, I think the moral of this one is just don't trust nobody. I don't care where I know you from. I don't care who I know you by. Do not trust anybody. And then on top of that, when God is giving you signs, sis, take those signs, because the signs are not for decoration. Take the signs and act accordingly. So this story time, this is somebody that I know, and it's somebody that I just didn't expect it to go the way it went. But now, if you need to book an appointment, you go on my website, you book an appointment, and, you know, keep it as is. But still, at the time, I wasn't giving no friend discounts or nothing like that, but I was a bit more lenient with my friends or people that I just knew in general, or just kind of thought, like, you know, like, I've known you, you know me type thing. I'm not going to expect you to, like, act any type of funny way or anything like that. But this one wasn't the case at all. So she texts me and I'm like, okay, cool. This is the appointment. I mean, this is the day that you want. This is the day I'm free, blah, blah, blah. We get a date set. Something comes up on her side and we have to move it. And I'm like, okay, cool. Mind you, there's no deposit. So it's like, you're telling me this either the night before or the day of. It's making the chances of me getting another client very, very low. So she tells me the first time, hey, can't make it, blah, blah, blah. Okay, cool, that's no problem. We can get it set for another time. We get it set for another time. The next time that we have our appointment set, she forgets the hair and she has to, or she forgets to get the hair or something like that. So she has to run to the beauty supply to get the hair. Okay, cool, that's fine, no problem. Go get the hair and as soon as you get back, we'll get it, you know, get it going. Hours go by and I'm in traffic, can't make it. Okay, cool, that's fine, that's no problem. We'll just do it for another day. We get it set for another day, and this time we actually get it set. So I do her hair, everything's going pretty smoothly. I'm not thinking, oh, you know, something's gonna happen. I'm not thinking anything. So I get her hair going. I finish her hair in a very, very timely manner. Her hair is done. Hair has been put in boiling water. I've trimmed it. Everything is good. Your mousse, I've massaged your scalp. I've done everything you need me to do. So it's time for you to pay me. So now pay me. So I'm pretty sure the excuse she used was that she's going to her apartment to go to the bank to get the money from her something. She's going to the bank to get the money. Same situation as the first story, right? But I think about an hour later, I'm like, where are you at? She said, I'm on my way to my dad's bank. I said, okay, bet. Go to your dad's bank, get the money, and I'll get it. At least by tonight, right? So I thought. So then this is 2 hours after she's left. She texts me again and she says, okay, I'm about to Zelle you the money. And I said, okay, here's my Zelle. Let me know when you send it. She goes, I'm about to send it soon. This is already an hour after the previous text. Then I started, you know, suspecting stuff, because it's like, it doesn't take you this long to, one, go to the bank, or two, send the money after, you know, you've already said I'm about to Zelle you the money. So I said, okay, it's been about 3 hours now. Don't make me start declining your services, because that's the last thing you want. She goes, I'm going to pay you today. I'm not postponing anything. My dad's card is stuck with some stupid issues right now. I already called him. He told me to wait so he could give me the money. He can't do it himself because blah, blah, blah. This is all just... like, I'm just reading this. I'm just like, okay, I don't care for the story. So then the next thing she texts me is her dad is about to be on his way home so he can get the car situation going. Whatever the heck story she wanted to go with, I was not believing it one bit. So I didn't even respond that same day. At this point, I was just like, I'm just going to give her the night to send the money. I didn't see anything that night. So then by the next morning, I text her. So I'm basically telling her, like, is it going to be sent this morning? Like, at this point, you know what I mean? Like, it's a lot of people that have tried to play me for money or have played me regarding money. And you can't lie, you know, from my perspective, it's not looking good for you right now. Like, everything seems fishy. Like, why is it taking you this long just to get money? You're telling me this story and this story. Send the money. It's okay. I don't care for the story. I apologize for whatever is going on with you, but send me the money. That's it. Basically just telling her that me allowing you to leave, first of all, you didn't give me any type of notice. You didn't kind of tell me. You sat in my chair for 7+ hours and you didn't as much as utter a single word as to, you know, hey, I don't have the money on me right now. I'm gonna go to my place, or I'm gonna go to the bank to get them. You didn't do anything. Okay, now I'm done with your hair and you're telling me you're about to go to the bank to get the money. What other choice do I have but to let you go to the bank to get the money? Like, I put trust in people so much sometimes, and I'm just let down so many times, and you know, this was one of those times that I was let down. But yeah, the story goes on. So she goes, I understand, I'm not that type of person, this and the third. She's saying that her dad has sent her the money and she's just going to send it to me. I said, okay, let me know when a good time is for me to expect it. No response. 2 hours later, like, give me a time right now. 3 hours later, at this point, you're really just effing with me. You're trying to see me blow up. So at this point, I'm like, okay, you're messing with me. And the last thing I'm going to do is allow you to get away with trying to F me over. It's not going to happen at all. So what I did was I texted her sister. I let her sister know, hey, this is what your sister is doing. I don't know if she's, you know, trying to pull out a scam. I don't know if she has some type of plot, but this is what's going on with your sister. She owes me X amount of money. I did her hair 2 days ago and I still have not gotten anything from her. As soon as I texted her sister, then she wants to respond. And she goes, I'm sorry, I fell asleep. You should be expecting it by today. Blah, blah, blah. I didn't even respond because I don't care what you're saying to me right now. If it's not a Zelle notification coming into my phone, I don't care. I don't care what it is. 4 hours later, she sends the money and she sends chunks at a time. I think first she sent 30, then she sent 50, then she was sending chunks. But basically the entire total I think was about 140 or 150. By the end of that third day, I only had $105. So I was like, when will you send the rest? I've only gotten 105 so far. She goes, today, I'll text you. Actually, this is a whole new day. I'm looking at the text. This is a whole new day. She goes, today, I'll text you before I send it. I said, okay, what time? She says, I don't know the time. This person owes me $70. Y'all know what's so funny though? One of my other friends had told me that she was asking them for money. Basically the same amount, $70, that she was asking them for $70. And obviously, I put two and two together, the $70 is supposed to go to me. Mind you, she's asking this person as in, hey, can you borrow me $70? The story that she texts me is that somebody owes her $70 that she's asking the person and she's just waiting on them to send it. Basically, at this point, the story keeps going. The lies keep flowing. Just BS after BS after BS. She's telling me now that her dad is not going to send her the money because her dad is paying her rent. So no, not her dad. So I'm like, okay, but that's the story you've been telling me the whole time. So why are you switching it up now? At this point, I don't care what the story is. Send me my money. That's literally all I care about. I don't care who has to pay rent. Then she tells me something about she has to pay Netflix, she has to pay this. I don't care what subscriptions you're signed to. I don't care who you owe money to. I don't care who owes you money. At this point, you owe me money and that's all I care about. Send me my money and we'll be good. Send me my money so I can be going. I just want to wash my hands clean. Send the money, that's it. Like, at this point, I'm pretty upset. Like, who wouldn't be? This is 3 days later. This is someone that I trusted. You didn't have to do any depositing. You didn't have to pay me a $25 deposit. You didn't have to go through my website. I've already given you so much leniency. And the fact that you think that you can use all of that and then still try to take advantage of me, no. So at this point, I'm pretty upset. I'm telling her, if you knew you didn't have the money on Saturday, if you knew you weren't going to pay everything in one chunk, why did you book your appointment? Because the thing is, if I remember clearly, the first time you booked your appointment was, 2 weeks ago? So you knew from 2 weeks ago that you had a hair appointment. You knew from 2 weeks ago what the price was. So why are you, like, people just don't. Long story short, she ends up sending the money in bits, of course, bit by bit by bit. So disrespectful, but I got my money. That's all that matters. She sent an extra $10, I guess, for the inconvenience, but still, As if it couldn't get any worse, this girl sends me the most disgusting message. She goes, okay, I would appreciate if we would let this go. Your services will no longer be needed. And this can stay between us. I know how your mouth works. Last time I checked, you don't know anything about me. It's funny though, because ironically, now I'm here telling YouTube about it. But it's just the disrespect, the nerve, first of all, the audacity. It's not looking good for you, sweetie. It's not looking good for you at all. Like, you look I just had to look at the message. I was like, you're disgusting. I got my money. That's all that matters. So yeah, basically what I learned with these two stories is, one, put yourself first. Put yourself first. Don't care how other people are gonna feel. Don't care about pleasing other people or making sure other people are good before you are good, because I'm very fond of doing that. It's a very, very bad habit of mine. And I didn't think it was a bad habit at first, because it's like, you know what? I care about people. Like, I'm very compassionate and I, you know, try to make sure that people are good. But as of lately, it's like, I come first. My peace of mind comes first. My sanity comes first. I'm sticking by my rules. Second of all, I don't want any type of trouble. Another thing is, don't do no friendship discounts. I know I didn't tell any stories with the friendship discounts, but sis, don't do any friendship discounts. They will get you absolutely nowhere, especially when you have college tuition, you got bills to pay, you got things to buy. Don't do any friendship discounts. Put yourself first. Put your pockets first. Yeah, demand pay up front if you need to. Stick by your rules. Put yourself first. Put your pocket first. And honestly, you should be good. But yeah, that's all with the story time. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. I hope you guys really picked up something from this. And if you didn't, it was for entertainment purposes. If you liked it, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.